Hello, I'm Fast Lawyer. Today we're going to do a review for Doctor Who, The Edge of Time VR, a game released on multiple storefronts, November 12th, 2019, by developer Maze Theory. On the Steam Store, it's available for the Valve Index, HTC Vive, and the Oculus Rift. It normally retails for $24.99. I actually bought this on the Oculus storefront on sale for $13. And I played two versions of this game. I played through the whole campaign on the Oculus Quest 2 standalone, and I want to say it took me about 3 hours to complete. I also played this game on PCVR, the Oculus Rift Store version, and there are two major differences between the Oculus Rift Store version and the Oculus Quest 2 standalone version. The biggest noticeable difference is the downgrade in graphics. This game looks so much better on the Oculus Rift Store version. So if you have a choice between the two, whether to play it with the Oculus Quest 2 standalone or to play it tethered to your PC, definitely play it tethered to your PC. It looks so much better. The other key difference is that there is bonus content on the Oculus Quest 2 storefront. However, that's not really a big deal. The Time Lord Victoria's content is really just cosmetic. You're just really chasing down collectibles while you're playing the game. In my opinion, it's totally not worth it, not a reason to be playing the standalone version. You can see on my video the difference between the standalone version graphics and the PCVR version. I label the two different versions in this video, and you can see the clear differences between the both of them. Due to the difference in graphical fidelity, I'm going to do something that I've never done before, and I'm going to give a different rating to the Oculus Quest 2 version and the PCVR version. There is a big drop off in graphics from PCVR on my RTX 3080 versus the Quest 2 standalone. It's just very noticeable. The Quest 2 version standalone is very ugly, and on PCVR is just a night and day difference. It looks so much better. It's nicer to explore the world when the resolution isn't as low as it is on the Quest 2 standalone version. So for that reason, I'm gonna give the PCVR version a higher rating, and I'll get to that at the end of this video. Doctor Who The Edge of Time is running on the Unity engine. On the PCVR version, I was getting a steady 90 frames per second. On my RTX 3080, I did not experience any serious issues or bugs. You do have full locomotion and smooth and snap turning options. You also have blinkers on as a comfort option. However, I turned mine off since I'm a VR veteran. Doctor Who The Edge of Time is a narrative driven game, so while there are some puzzles, the puzzles are not the focus of the game, and I won't call them easy, but they're not exactly difficult either. I think these are casual type puzzles, perfect if you're a casual puzzle type fan. Just don't expect a lot of puzzles. The focus here is just really on the narrative driven story, and if you're a Doctor Who fan, I think you might enjoy the story. It was nice. It really didn't capture my attention, but also I'm not a big Doctor Who fan. I'm aware of the Doctor Who universe, but I'm definitely not the targeted audience. I think there's a lot of background information that you need to be aware of in order to fully enjoy this episode. This really does play out almost like a TV episode of Doctor Who, and I've only seen like maybe 2 or 3 episodes of Doctor Who, so I'm definitely not the biggest expert on the Doctor Who universe, but I was able to follow along. If you're not familiar at all with the Doctor Who universe, you might be more confused than I was, but I was pretty much able to follow along with the story, and it is my understanding that as far as the voice acting, that the main Doctor portrayed is one of the actors in the 10th season of the show. And I'm sorry if that information is incorrect. Like I said, I'm not a big fan of the show, but that's my understanding. As far as the story as portrayed in this game, I definitely think it could have had more depth to it, but I do think the way it's written is common with how the TV episodes go. It's a little on the hokey side, but I think that's part of the charm of the Doctor Who universe. I don't think the show really takes itself too seriously. There's some clear good guys and there's some clear bad guys. There's some big catastrophic universal wrong that needs to be righted, some big catastrophe that needs to be fixed, and by the end of the show, you fixed it and you're the hero, and I think that's part of the charm of the show and why there are so many fans for this show. And so I really can't criticize the voice acting, because I think the voice acting does go along with the motif of the show. And so for the purposes of the TV show, I do think the voice acting here meets the mark for its intended audience. It's not my personal cup of tea, but I do think fans of the show will enjoy the fan service, the nods to the TV show using the real actor, and just some of the tools used that are part of the show, including the TARDIS or the sonic screwdriver. And like I said, the puzzles are casual level puzzles, so if you're a puzzle veteran, you probably will not enjoy the puzzles in this game. There's also some shooting towards the end of this game. That was probably the worst thing about this game. So overall, if I have to rate Doctor Who The Edge of Time PCVR, I would give it a 6 out of 10. I do think there's enough here so that fans of the show will really love this game. However, if you're not a fan of the show, I don't think you'll like the easy puzzles, the poor shooting, and just the hokey story overall. So I don't think this game is definitely intended at all for non-fans of the show. And as I said, for the PCVR version, I'm giving the higher score. So that means for the Oculus Quest 2 standalone version, I'm only going to give a 5 out of 10. Yes, the visuals on the Oculus Quest 2 standalone version are that horrible. It's an ugly game to look at on the Oculus Quest 2. There's just no getting around that. For a game that relies on nostalgia, on enjoyment of the TV show, it's very important that you have nice enough visuals for you to get that nostalgia, for you to enjoy this like an episode of the TV show. But when the visuals are this poor, it really doesn't meet its mark, and it just doesn't on the Oculus Quest 2. So I'm only going to give that a 5 out of 10. Anyways, I'm Fast Lawyer. If you enjoyed my review, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And as always, have a wonderful day and enjoy the rest of the video.
Good. Now, we just have to wait for the lift to reactivate. Keep your wits about you. Nice and steady. Okay, so that's why the Weeping Angel in the painting gave us the key. It wasn't helping us. It wanted us down here, so we'd have to face these angels.
Things got pretty hectic back there.
We make quite a good team, don't we?
What took you so long? While you've been sightseeing and taking it easy, I've been doing the donkey work and finding out what's behind the reality virus. First things first, though. I can detect a force is trying to fix us in a tractor beam. I'm not having that. I'm going to remote pilot the TARDIS away from Earth. Back in a tick. And you might want to find something to hang on to.
Okay, pull the activation lever and let's go.